Beautiful broadleaf forests, rolling hills, broken only by white cliffsides and valleys. It is autumn in Germany's southern Harz Mountains. Water seeps through gypsum rock and dissolves it. This is how the so-called Keller developed over thousands of years. A semi-open grotto. Gypsum rock has shaped the entire area. This unique landscape is a refuge for both endangered animals and plant species, right in the center of Germany. But a cloud hangs over the bucolic landscape. The gypsum found here is in high demand. The white building material, an integral part of many screeds and plasters, is to be found in all sheets of drywall. Gypsum rock is unearthed in large open pit mines like here in the southern Harz Mountains. Around 10 million tons of gypsum are processed every year in Germany. And the pressure to mine these natural deposits will continue to increase in the coming years. Up until now, around half of the white building material has been obtained at the site of coal-fired power plants. The sulfur dioxide contained in the fumes is washed out here and chemically treated. The flue gas desulfurization process produces high purity FGD gypsum. But experts are warning us that this kind of gypsum production will end by 2038 at the latest. With coal-fired power plants scheduled to shut down, the amount of FGD gypsum available will continue to decrease, which means the drive for natural sources will increase. In order to conserve natural resources, alternatives to FGD gypsum are urgently needed. Over the next few years, thousands of buildings will be demolished or refurbished in Germany, resulting in millions of tons of construction waste every year. And there is plenty of gypsum to be found in old plasterboard, gypsum screeds, or even special plasters. A waste disposal company based in central Germany sees these materials as an important resource. When taking down houses or renovating them, there are various building materials that are amassed, such as stone, brick, and wood, but also plasterboard. This is wonderful. It can be reused. We can recycle it in this form. In Germany, there are currently about 650,000 tons of construction waste containing gypsum, although only about half of it is recyclable, because the other half is interspersed with contaminants. The structure of drywall is simple. Between two thin cardboard surfaces, there is a layer of pure gypsum. Every year, around 30,000 tons of fragments end up at the Mitteldeutsche Umwelt und Entsorgung GmbH in Saxony. The bits of drywall had been previously separated from other construction waste in a process known as selective deconstruction. An excavator transports the material to a large container. Here it is crushed for the first time. Then the broken pieces are placed on conveyor belts and moved into another hall. There, another round of crushing is done in special machines, and the gypsum powder is then sieved off. After the material has gone through the process of crushing and sieving several times, three different categories of material have been created. A very fine gypsum powder with a grain size of 0 to 2 millimeters, shredded cardboard of various sizes, as well as gypsum granules with a grain size from 2 to 8 millimeters. This is our recycled gypsum of 2 to 8 millimeters. This will go back to the gypsum plant as a raw material. There it is calcined and then processed into new plasterboard. Before the two gypsum categories are processed back into drywall, technicians examine the material. There are more than 40 different parameters that are checked. The asbestos and heavy metal content is also determined. Around 350,000 tons of gypsum could be recycled every year using this process. However, that would only make up around 4% of Germany's total demand for gypsum. In order to recycle a more significant amount of gypsum, engineers at the Institute of Applied Construction Research in Weimar developed and then built a completely new recycling plant that enables special gypsum plasters to be recycled. Even screeds, which are often mixed with other materials after demolition, can be recycled. We develop strategies to increase the amount that can be recycled, for example, with materials like when gypsum is firmly stuck to bricks, things that normally cannot be further processed. The first step, the unsorted mineral construction waste, is crushed in a so-called jaw crusher. The result is a mixture of different building materials, with a size from 8 to 63 millimeters. Some parts contain gypsum, some do not. It includes parts like this brick, for example. Plaster had been applied many years ago. It couldn't have been recycled until now. In the new plant in Weimar, material containing gypsum is separated from other construction waste in a further step. The engineers use a special machine for this. The construction waste falls through a hopper into a shaft illuminated with powerful lamps. A number of cameras detect the materials in the shaft. The cameras can recognize different colors quite accurately. Before the cutting process begins, the red brick with the white plaster has been scanned from every perspective. In the stream of materials, the cameras can detect gypsum among the other building materials. Air pressure nozzles then blow the gypsum out of the stream. This optical freefall sorter can process 10 tons of construction waste per hour. It can blow out up to 6 different materials simultaneously and separate them by type. This flow aimed to collect the bricks with gypsum plaster in a separate group. After that, the bricks are ground into powder with the gypsum, and a so-called expanding agent is added. In another hall in the plant, water is added to produce spheres with a diameter of 4 to 8 millimeters. The granules contain the gypsum, the ground brick, and the expanding agent, silicon carbide. The engineers in Weimar then feed the material into the final step of their recycling process. It falls through a shaft into a special rotary kiln. The rotary kiln is 6 meters long. Inside, it has a gas flame that heats the material to 1,200 degrees Celsius. Due to the slight incline and a slight rotation in the furnace, the granules move towards the flame. A glass-like melt is formed at such an extremely high temperature here. In this hot zone, the diameter of the beads doubles. They're porous and therefore permeated with air. In addition, the sulfur contained in the gypsum outgasses as sulfur trioxide. The sulfur trioxide is drawn off in the flue gas from the rotary kiln. The granules, still glowing and bloated, fall onto a plate at the lower end of the furnace. Here they can cool. The result is a porous, permeable building material that can be used by the construction industry. Engineers can monitor the entire process via cameras and sensors. By using green hydrogen or green electricity, the energy demand can be achieved climate neutrally. The sulfur trioxide contained in the flue gas is also separated with the aid of a flue gas scrubber, similar to a coal-fired power plant. In addition to the granules from the rotary kiln, high purity gypsum is also produced. Since air is enclosed in the granules, they are even lighter than water. Lightweight concrete blocks can be made from the gray beads, among other things. These bricks have a relatively high strength combined with low weight and a high thermal insulation value. Previously, such a building material was also made from a natural substance. Lightweight concrete blocks are made of natural clay, expanded natural clay. We can replace this with our granules, so we help to save the environment because we can replace natural resources. We can recycle all of that. It no longer has to be shipped to a landfill. But for that to happen, the political framework first has to be changed to make it economically viable. If this new technology from Weimar were to be used throughout Germany, up to 20% of the gypsum needed here could be recovered from construction waste. In addition, other building materials could also be recycled like this, thereby conserving even more natural resources. But the new process has to be profitable, of course. Of all the plants that recycle plasterboard, 4 of them are in Germany. The problem is, almost all of them are only utilized to about 50% of their capacity. A large proportion of the gypsum plasterboard separated during demolition work does not end up here, but rather in landfills. Despite the fact that, according to the law, recycling is to be given preference over landfills. If the potential that these innovative technologies offer were put to serious use, we could better protect our natural resources and better preserve our natural habitats.